Andy.
This is Xavier.
And this morning we are going to be doing a little woodworking project with you. We're going to be making some yarn art. Let's go.
And before we actually make our yarn art, we'll just go over some safety procedures. And we'll also tell you about the equipment that we have here. All right, just to go over our equipment today, we have our workstation here. Just make sure if you're doing this at home, you have an area that is safe and you have some a nice size area to work with. We have our safety goggles. Just make sure you're wearing safety goggles at all times. We have our scrap wood. If you're doing this at home, just talk to your parents or you can go find a piece of scrap wood. It doesn't have to be too big. This is a great size for it. Here's a little example that we made yesterday. We also have a claw hammer. You can use any type of hammer that you need to, but today we're going to work with a claw hammer. We have our pencils so we can draw our marks on our scrap wood so we know where our finished nails go. We also have an eraser just in case we don't like our project and we want to start over. Or we put a dot in the wrong spot, you can erase it and you can start over just from right there. We also have our yarn that we are going to wrap around our nails, which we will get to in a little bit. And then last but not least, we have our finished nails.
The important part today, with all of you working at home, hopefully with your parents, okay, is our woodworking safety rules. And we follow these here at Fairview Lake when we do classes for woodworking. The first thing we want to talk about is our attitude and behavior. So hey, we want to be respectful at all times here in the woodworking shop. I'm not getting the equipment and throwing it around. I'm always being respectful with the equipment and respectful to each other. I've got to be nice to Xavier in here this morning. Next up, be mindful of your environment. Like Xavier said previously, hey, we want to be working in a space which is comfortable for us to work in. All right, so I'm probably not doing this in a tiny little bedroom where I could hurt myself. Things will go wrong. Hey, that is what this big eraser's for. Don't worry if you make a mistake, it's your own project. We will have a great time today. And hey, we are a community. Don't worry if you need to ask for help, do it. Ask your parents, ask your friends, ask your brothers and sisters for help. And our technique, we've always got to be wearing appropriate safety gear. So that's why we've got our nice safety goggles, okay? And we'll be being very careful when we are hammering those nails into the wood, all right? Operate the tools only after receiving the right training. Thankfully, me and Xavier are trained with our maple wood shop working stations, so we will be good to go and teach you what you're doing, but ask a parent at home. Hold wood with the vices and workstations. This is what this solid piece of wood here is on the table, all right? Let the tool do the work. You don't want to get yourself tired. Keep hands away from the cutting edges and make sure when you are all finished, clean up at home. Thank you.
All right, step one, make sure you are putting your safety goggles on. Step two, grab a pencil and you can make a design. Now, when you make your design, you can either make a design just using dots or you can draw a big picture and then you can put the dots wherever you want on your picture and then you can wrap the yarn around that. So, I'm gonna start off by drawing a design. So today, I'm going to be drawing the letter X. So very simple. I'm going to make an X and I am going to make it with box. And I kind of made my lower part a little skinny, but like I said, we have an eraser, so we can always fix that. All right. Now, I have my X. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put dots where I want the yarn to walk around or wrap around. So I'm going to put dots at the corners. And then I'll put a couple in the middle, just so my yarn is not too flimsy and it has another spot to hold on to. Perfect.
Okay, so for this next step, the equipment that you are gonna need, obviously your safety goggles still, you're gonna need your claw hammer and your finishing nails, all right? So, like I said earlier, when we are using our hammer, we're not going with big swings because that's how we get hurt, okay? All we are doing at our workstation, okay, we are finding where Xavier put those dots, okay? So we're gonna start just here. And what we do, we get the finishing nail, we put it on the dot, and what we do is tap, tap, bang. Tap, tap, bang. Tap, tap, bang. Tap, tap, bang. Okay, now, we'll do that for a couple of times, but remember, because we are putting yarn in here, we don't have to put the finishing nail all the way through, okay? We still need that nail out there so we can put that yarn on, all right? So we'll carry on with this, and we'll come back with you with the next step in a minute.
All right, so Andy finished putting all the nails in. Just a reminder, you don't need to put the nails all the way through because we need room for our yarn to be tight across our nails. Now, next step, and one thing we forgot to add in, make sure you get a pair of scissors. They don't need to be too sharp because all you're doing is cutting yarn. So make sure you have a pair of scissors with you. And then the next step is grabbing any type of yarn you want to. You can do this with multiple colors. Today I have the camo color. And
where is it?
I know some of you can't see it because it's camo, but I have camo string in my hand. So the next step is I cut a strip off from my wrap of yarn. Now, you are going to find a starting point. So I am gonna start at the end, one of the ends of my X. And I am going to start by making a knot. And no worries, you can cut off the loose end. So just a regular knot. All right, and I'm gonna wrap it around one of my nails and tie it tight. And then once you go down the line, you don't have to make a knot on each one. All you have to do is wrap it so you can have the tension in your yarn. So you can wrap it once or twice. Here, I'm gonna wrap it twice. One, two. And I'm gonna go to my next nail. One, two. And then at the end, I am going to measure out a nice length. So I'll cut it around 2 inches from the end. And I'll do my one, two. And then when I have that, I will cut off the ends. And you want to repeat that step for every single line. So we will repeat the steps and then we will show you the finished project.
We have got our final design just here, okay? Look at that. Good work from me and Xavier, right? So that's our final design. We'd love to see your designs. So once you have made them at home, please send in your photos or your videos of you making your yarn art.
Thank you for tuning in to our yarn art class today. Like Andy said, please make sure you show us what you made. We just want to let you know to have a Fairview Lake kind of day, and we will see you very soon.
Hey, goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.